All right, Leonidas Leatherworks here. Let's do a video on sizing suspenders, particularly where your turnout bottoms have the button type attachment set. Okay, and this is for crossback suspenders, not the H-back. It's close, but it's a little bit different. Okay, so first, start with a seamstress tape. Get one. Okay, find one they're readily available. You can get them on Amazon, you can get them multiple places. If you're a local department that I'm working with, I'll provide you a seamstress tape. Okay, in lieu of a seamstress tape, if you just absolutely cannot find one, then you can use a thin piece of rope or flexible material. Take your measurements, marking those kind of on the rope, and then lay it on the ground next to a yardstick and or a tape measure. Best thing, seamstress tape. Okay, so I've removed one half of this gentleman's suspenders. We're fitting him for a new set. We're going to take a new measurement. So here we go, right? We are going to, one, use a partner. If you try to do this yourself, it just doesn't quite work so hot. Okay, so get a partner. Position your turnout bottoms in the orientation that you want your suspenders to support them. So if I want them, you have to sit here, then kind of hold them there and let your partner take that measurement. Don't, you know, let them sit low, take that measurement and expect your suspenders to really hold you tight. Yes, your suspenders will be adjustable, but we're gonna try and design your suspenders so they fit the best with your hole in the middle position. Okay, so starting to take the measure, I'm gonna do two measurements. One is the primary measurement. That's the overall front to back measurement. Okay, I'm gonna start between the two buttons and I'm gonna start about the mid height of the buttons. Okay, I'm gonna run up the chest. Okay, kind of positioning those how I want the suspenders to possibly lay. And we're gonna go not too close to the neck, but a little bit on the shoulder area. That's where we want that suspender to provide you support. I'm going to go on the back side and measure to the opposite side. So in this case, I'm measuring from left front to the right rear. Okay, let's turn him around. Pardon my reach, sir. Show you the back side. Okay, so here we are. I'm measuring down and across. Kind of position those suspenders where I want, or the turnouts where I want them. So for here, I would say, okay, he'll take a measurement of 39 inches. Okay. Take a measurement on the opposite side. They should be very close to each other, within an inch. So if you measure 39 and you measure the opposite side 39, perfect. If you measure 39 on one side, and the opposite side comes up with a measurement that's just a little bit different, like 38, you know, within an inch, then consider splitting the difference and reporting the measurement to be 38 and a half. Okay, you want to pick which one you're going to favor, 38, 39, 38 and a half. We're going to try and build your suspenders so that they are identical on each side. Barring any postural issue or one leg significantly longer than the other, tilted hips, those kind of things. Maybe you know turnouts that have a flaw in them or something. Really, both these measurements are going to be the same. Okay, so that is the primary measurement. Front on one side to the opposite rear on the other side, measuring from between the two buttons on each side. Pardon my reach, sir. Do-si-do. I don't recommend you do that with your partner. Okay, so the opposite measurement is going to be a measurement to determine the maximum height that we want your buckle to sit. So we're going to measure from the midpoint button location start zone to the height, which I think I want the buckle to sit maximally. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to measure from here, okay, starting between the two buttons, running up the body to a height where like, okay, his chest starts here. So at maximum, perhaps I want that buckle, the very top of the buckle, to hit 9 inches. if it pushed to 10 or 11, then maybe that wouldn't be so comfortable because it's going to be rubbing on a sensitive area. Okay, we don't want that. Most of it'll be okay. You know, the underside is fairly smooth, but let's position your buckles so they sit beneath your chest. You also don't want to sit that buckle too low, because if we put the buckle very low, then it won't have the space it needs for your two leather attachment pieces to come up towards the buckle. So we need some space there. Generally, right underneath the chest is going to be your best option. So tell me from there, what's the maximum height you want your buckle to sit? And we're gonna make that the location for your buckle. Okay, that is the secondary measurement. So with those two measurements, we should be able to build you a nice fitting set of suspenders in the crossback configuration. Okay, thanks.